Well, even with the heroic word of Khaled Omar and others like him pulling victims from the rubble, there's no sense of safety once they're rescued. An almost complete lack of supplies at hospitals means doctors are often faced with impossible choices. Well, a little while ago, I was joined by Dr. David Knott, who's been faced with some himself. He began by telling me about some surgeons he's trained there and still talks to.
I've been in contact with them. I left Aleppo in October 2014, but since that time I've been in constant contact with them on various social media, WhatsApp, so I know exactly what's going on. I know exactly what cases they're dealing with because I taught them all how to operate back in 2013 and 14, and have a very strong family-type relationship with them. And so we're always constantly talking to each other all the time. And they're not going to go. They're going to stay there to the bitter end.
What is a typical operating theatre like when the equipment that is available in Aleppo right now?
Well, of course, since about a month or so now, the siege has started and things can't get in. And we used to use a lot of equipment. We used to use a lot of surgical items like swabs, lots of gowns, lots of surgical equipment, which we need all the time, chest drains, chest tubes and so on. And the problem is you can't get any access to that sort of equipment. Mm-hmm. You know, you're not going to be able to do as much as you possibly can. Not only that, they're receiving, I know for a fact, mass casualties. So they're receiving not just one or two cases every hour or so, but they're receiving 20 casualties on the go. And not only that, they're receiving the intensity of the airstrikes at the moment is so intense that they're having lot to deal with lots of fragmentation wounds in children and families.
When it comes to who to treat, the letter from the doctors, they specifically said there that they're having to make that decision which child to treat, which patient to look after first. Have you personally had to confront that decision as well?
Yes, all the time. In fact, when I was there in 2014, it was as bad in 2014 as it is today, although the intensity of the airstrikes is significantly worse today than it was in 2014. We used to have mass casualties coming in, and we also were running out of equipment, so it's very difficult to make the decision exactly who to operate on. If you've got somebody that requires 20 units of blood, then you haven't got 20 units of blood to give that patient. You've got to rationalize the blood for the last 10 patients that you have, so you have to let that patient die.
From your experience and from what we're seeing today, there's been a lot of talk about hospitals being targeted deliberately as military targets now, doctors being targeted. Do you think that that is a recurring theme now, and that the 15 doctors in particular in Aleppo, that they know that wherever they are and wherever they are treating their patients, they are in the firing line as well?
Absolutely. I mean, the most dangerous place to be in Aleppo at the moment is to be in a hospital, and everybody knows that. And so the doctors are all targeted, hospitals are all targeted. I worked in one of the hospitals in 2014, and I understand from the chairman of OSUM, which is the Union of Syrian NGOs, that in fact the hospital I worked in has been targeted, and 70% of that hospital has now been completely destroyed. And that hospital was underground, and it must have been targeted by a high explosion to cause that damage.
But what has to happen to see a change in course, just from to avoid a continuation of the last 5 years?
Well, now is a crucial time, really, because if we don't do something now, the situation will get catastrophically worse. It's absolutely right that the doctors should have written to President Obama, and now it's his chance, as he's leaving office, to finally do something. And I think what he should do, plus all the prime ministers of Europe, they should all get together and they should all go and see President Putin, sit round the table and sort this problem out.